How did you feel about the scene of Zoya and Dinesh in the trailer and about Zoya's poster? Glorious? Great, because I have a theory about that. Hi and welcome back. I will paint Captain Gaffa here on the right while I propose a new theory I have about Shadow and Bone Season 2, and it might be a spoiler if I guessed, so feel free to not watch this if you want to be sure that the surprise is still there. Also, there will be book spoilers from Ruin and Rising, King of Scars and Lives of Saints, maybe even Rule of Wolves. I would like to clear that I did not see or hear any plot leaks, I just pieced together a possible outcome for Zoya and Dinesh, or from the official trailer, cast interviews and fan discussions. So let's start. Anyone who has listened to the interviews will have realized by now that half the plot for the Crows happens in Ketterdam, after which Dinesh has a path of her own, and you know from the trailer that it has something to do with Shuhan. On the Alina side, we can guess that both the plot of Siege of Storm and either a part of the entire plot of Ruin and Rising will be there, because we expect that both the last two amplifiers are going to be hunted in this season. We have also heard that the showrunners want to get 4th season from Netflix, and there were talks for bigger plans for the adaptation of Six of Crows, some of the rumors surrounding a spin-off, but I guess bigger plans could also mean film. In any case, it seems logical that season 3 will not be the plot of Six of Crows, which will be done separately, and the Shadow and Bone show will have to skip forward or rearrange the timeline in order to adapt in King of Scars. Additionally, there is one extra Grishaverse book that we know has inspired something in season 2, and Leigh Bardugo confirmed that it's The Lives of Saints. Now, in order to start season 3 with King of Scars material, there needs to be left a door open by the time season 2 ends, and in the trailer there might or might not be one. We know that the Fold was destroyed at the end of Ruin and Rising, and the barren desert infused with Merzost or dark magic was left in its wake, which could be this desert here from which the Nichevoya sprang up. Now, King of Scars refocuses its attention on Zoya and Nikolai, but the readers of Rule of Wolves know that Zoya has a huge role. Also, at the end of season 1, Zoya was about to return into the Fold to search for her own, but what if she returns there and instead of people she finds something else, namely the palace where Juris and Elisaveta live, but the Fold not being destroyed yet, what if she has to return with reinforcements? We also see this creature that looks like a dragon in the trailer, and at first I thought it could either be the Sea Whip or Juris himself, but in the new video they released yesterday, they seem to indicate that it's the Sea Whip, so I'm not sure about that. Keep all this in mind, and now remember Inej's expedition to Shuhan and something from The Lives of Saints. I asked my Instagram followers what part of Lives of Saints could this be, and it was speculated that it could be Juris or Gregory, but the one that makes more sense is Sankt Anear and Sankt Kopp. Just to clear things out, I wasn't the first to come up with this theory, it was told to me by someone who had been told by someone else. Now, the Two Saints story features a magical sword that was used to kill an indestructible army, and now remember that Kaz mentioned the Darkling's indestructible army, and this magical sword is in the capital of Shuhan, Amrathien, so it would be a perfect haste for Inej. Coming back to the desert thing in the trailer, see Inej holding a sword and look how similar it is to the sword in the Lives of Saints illustration. Now what if Inej wielding the magic sword is Zoya reinforcement to enter the dark magic infused desert in order to get to Zoya's new amplifier Juris? I for one, the first time I saw this poster, I thought that Zoya looks majestic, and also look at this picture of Zoya in this magnificent dress that is not a kefta, but seems to be something more. I think they could be hinting at something, that they are already setting Zoya on the path for season 3, which will center on her journey with the involvement of the Crows and the other characters. How amazing would that be? I know Sujaya Dasgupta does not appear much in season 2 because she was busy filming Shantaram, but I think it would be beyond fantastic to see Zoya start on her new bigger journey aided by Inej. Anyway, it's just a theory, but I love to hear your opinions on this possibility, so drop your thoughts in the comments and see you after the release of season 2 with new discussion material. Until then, check out these other two season 2 commentaries I've done, or take a look at the merchandise with Crow Art I have in my Redbubble shop. See you next time. Bye!